Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through multicast routing. Guys, I am saying initially only because I am not so that much clear about this topic. So I will be just introducing you and giving you an example. If you are searching for a detailed explanation on multicast routing, this is not the correct video for you guys. Okay, so I didn't find any kind of explanation in detail about multicast routing. So I just took some points from the textbook. I understood them and I wrote them in my own words. And I took a small example, guys. So that's what I am explaining now. Okay. So let us continue. So multicast routing. Sending a message to a group or a large group is called as multicast. So here at a time you can send for multiple people, guys. Okay. So multicasting refers to group management. So basically I told you a group of people. So now you need to maintain a group, right? So now you need to manage it. So you need to create it and you need to destroy it when its work is done. And you need to allow processes to join or leave the group. It's just like your WhatsApp group, guys. You can create a group, you can delete the group, you can invite your friends, or you can leave the group. If you are a member, you can leave the group, right? Yes. So to do multicast routing, each of the router computer has a span and tree covering all the nodes. So basically assume that this is the whole tree, guys. So these are some of your friends. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, sorry, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So assume you are having 11 friends. Among which two members are in group 1 and 2 and only 1, 2, 3. 3 members are in group 1 and 3 members are in group 2. Okay, so these are the groups which they are in, guys. Okay, so if you construct a spanning tree for this just by removing loops. So let us remove this, let us remove this. Okay, are there any more loops again here? Let us remove this. All loops are gone. So we'll be getting a spanning tree, simple. Right? So once you got the spanning tree, now just to divide this into two different groups, guys. So group 1 here and group 2 here. So if you divide it in that way, so you'll be getting the result in this way. So this is the group 1 spanning tree and group 2 spanning tree. So if you start from here, you can just flood the message to these members only. That is the advantage here. So here the number of messages which are going will also get reduced. Simple? Yes. So these are the group 1 members and these are the group 2 members. So I hope everyone got some basic idea. Sorry for not explaining in detail, guys, because I also didn't understand that much about it. Okay. So I hope it will be clear for you. At least a bit of small idea you'll be getting. Okay. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through congestion, guys. Okay. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.